Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And have you watched any Christmas specials lately?
I have.
Have you watched this Christmas special?
Hell no, and I'm not going to.
Yeah, Santa Inc. on HBO Max is the lowest rated TV show ever on IMDb. It is a garbage tier shit show, from what I understand, and Seth Rogen is blaming white supremacists.
Of course he is.
For the backlash.
Of course he is. I want to go on record before we start this video as saying we have not watched this show.
No.
We are not going to watch this series show. What we're talking about in this video is more about his reaction and the way he's behaving than it is the show. Because I didn't see the show, so I can't speak to the show other than the trailer, which was pretty shit. So it's going to stick to what his behavior is for the most part.
Yeah, and Seth Rogen's behavior has been very erratic lately. We'll talk about some of that. Seth Rogen, saying, hey, it's totally cool if your car got broken into. LA is fine. It's all fine. Just go buy a new car.
He's been doing this shit for a while. Honestly, to be completely honest with you, I think the only reason he stays relevant at all is because he has these little hissy fits that keeps him in the news. I know he was having a hissy fit a couple years ago about something else. I don't even remember what it was, but they all blend together. It's just, I, in my head, associate bad behavior hissy fit with him.
He used to be kind of the everyman, character. Like, I he was kind of relatable, and then he just, I don't know what the hell happened. I don't know. Just today, Seth Rogen was extremely high while in the front row for the Adele TV
and
special.
And water is wet.
Who
it's
the
a
hell
day
cares?
That ends in Y. Seth Rogen was high, you don't say.
I think that explains everything. Now, what is concerning?
Oh, it's Kevin Smith. That's an interesting connection here. I'm just saying, they both are kind of acting the same way.
Don't smoke the devil's lettuce, children. Don't move to Hollywood and don't smoke the devil's lettuce, because this is what happens. What is highly concerning about Seth Rogen?
This is the first thing I thought of, too.
We are huge fans of Darkwing Duck.
And it's not just that. It's Rescue Rangers, too. Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers.
Shit.
It's both of them, I believe.
So, drama queen, pothead, Seth Rogen.
Sausage Party guy.
Sausage Party Seth Rogen. That's his name. Sausage Party Seth Rogen is going to do Darkwing Duck.
Disney thought that would be a great person to put in charge of not only Darkwing Duck, but Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers.
Oh my God, it's going to be Darkwing Fuck, isn't it?
I don't think so. I don't. And you make that joke, but it's funny. It's amazing what happens on your phone, because I know one time Neon was writing his editor when he was doing Disney Duck stuff, and it auto-corrected it to the F word.
It did. So. Weirdly enough, because I didn't. Yeah, usually it's the other way around. Like if you're trying to swear and it sounds like, poopy poop 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 duck,
like,
duck face.
Oh, F. Oh no, it'd be duck. It's like no, duck F.
I said this is my editor. I worked on Scrooge McDuck comics for a number of years, and I said I will have more duck pages for you later tonight. It came out. I will have more fucks for you later tonight. Because
yes.
I'm all out of fucks right now.
Yes.
Fuck well has run dry.
It does, could argue that maybe there's some, fuck is the pens of it autocorrected. Sorry, Mom.
I just, Disney, turn back Pinocchio.
Yeah.
Turn back, please. God, we're going to talk about Santa Inc. Yeah.
Well, it could be good. Not Santa Inc. Not Santa Inc. The Chip, the Rescue Rangers and Darkwing, because they might have a lot of oversight. But it's Disney, so.
It's Disney Plus.
And it's current year Disney.
Yeah, they'll just crap it out.
Because they're just trying to get content up. So, let's try benefit of the doubt until we prove it otherwise.
I think that's what happened here, because HBO Max, to be completely fair, we're not saying they sent stuff before, but we've also been very critical. But they've actually, as far as animated content goes, they've actually been pretty good. I think this is one of those things where it's like, oh yeah, Sausage Party was kind of a hit, and Christmas special, we need some content. Come on over.
Adult Christmas special sounds good in theory, but there are limits that even adults will, be like, these are crossed. And I think that from what it sounds like to me is the case here. And a lot of critics don't like it either.
So let's talk about that before we get into it any further. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. Over 244,000 subs. We do talk about the animation industry. We talk about Disney. Talk about Hollywood. Talk about Hollywood weirdos. And Seth Rogen, unfortunately, has become a Hollywood weirdo as of late. Because not only is this movie just a terrible idea on every level, right? Mm-hmm. Poorly executed, completely slammed by critics, slammed by audiences, downvoted to hell. Look at this.
Oh, yes. Even though it's hidden, you can still see it with apps and stuff. And this was a little bit ago. This is yesterday afternoon. I'm sure it's considerably worse now.
109,000 downvotes on the trailer on HBO Max.
That was hidden.
It's gotten so bad that they turn the comments off.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's got over 500,000 views, but you know, we've got little nuggets like this. You know, good news, sir. More American kids believe in you than they do vaccines or the Holocaust. Ho-ho! That's some funny shit.
Yeah, meanwhile, Gina Carano got fired for saying what she said, and they're allowed to just make jokes about the Holocaust in this Christmas special. But they're allowed to because they're them.
They're them. Yeah, very ill-conceived. Santa Inc., starring Seth Rogen, becomes the lowest-rated TV show ever on IMDb. That is really, really impressive, Seth. Rogen stars as Santa Claus. Of course he does. He's going to be Donkey Kong too.
Well, let's hope they change their mind on that one. Well, he's an ass, so that's about right.
Stars as Santa Claus, a problematic white male. If you watch the trailer, it was all about the problematic white men that have the mantle of Santa.
Is that what it is?
Yes. Yes. They're all country club together and yeah.
Okay.
It's exactly what you thought it would be.
I have no desire to see it because I'm not going to support it. And, you know, don't give a shit about it.
I mean, you could have made a funny adult Christmas special.
Could have been, yeah.
Without the politics. It could have just been, you know, Santa's sausage party.
Yeah. Well, apparently there's a lot of jokes about oral sex and stuff like that in this show.
Come on, everybody. It's time to get so naughty. It's Santa's sausage party. Yeah, that could have been fun. That actually could have been fun. Christmas sausage.
I gotta tell you, I do not ever want to see Santa and sausage party in the same thing. I just can't do it. My mind can't handle that.
This new comedy series. I thought it was just a special.
No, it's a series.
Holy shit! There's more than one.
Yep.
Doesn't seem to be bringing joy to the world. Santa Inc., a new HBO Max series released on December 2nd, has scored staggeringly low Rotten Tomatoes scores. Yeah, it's like 3%.
But it's just the white supremacists, guys. It's only a vocal minority that voted it down to 3%, even though if you actually look at the downvotes that aren't hidden or that use the app to unhide the downvotes on the trailer on YouTube, it's 109,000 plus.
Who knew there were so many Yahtzees out there gunning for this Christmas special that probably nobody heard of other than to shit on it. I mean, let's be honest. Like nobody, I didn't even know this was a thing.
I did, but I didn't care.
That's pretty much.
I guess my thing is what I was looking at it was, it's not for me, but other people might like it. So I wasn't going to say anything about it either way because I wasn't going to watch it and I didn't want to unfairly judge something. The only reason we're mentioning it at all is because of the way Seth Rogen is behaving and it's typical current year Hollywood bullshit. And that's how he's behaving.
Yeah. So it received an average audience score of 3% on Rotten Tomatoes, IMDb rating of 1.1 out of 10. The series now takes the top spot on IMDb's list of lowest rated TV shows, beating out a 2005 Hungarian drama that received a 1.4 out of 10 rating.
Wow.
Why is it ruffle feathers? It's political.
That's basically
it's
I think.
It's political and raunchy.
It's raunchy, is my understanding. And, you know, hey, some people like that, and that's cool. You're allowed to like it. but
we really pissed off tens of thousands of white supremacists with our new show. No, Seth Rogen, I think you were high when you came up with the idea. Why somebody gave you money is beyond me. And please, for the love of God, Disney, you don't do much right these days. Do not let this man near Darkwing Duck.
Too late. I think Rescue Rangers already done. Okay, look, this is what we're talking about. Okay, so it doesn't do well. It performs badly. And I guess among these comments, I haven't read them all. Apparently, they're using that. There are some anti-Semitic comments in among this. And there probably are. I'm not going to say there aren't because there probably are. And they're going to run with that and say that they're bullied, they're oppressed, and that everyone downvoting it ever is because they are white supremacists.
Yeah.
Including people that aren't white. It doesn't matter. They're probably, you know, misogynistic and racist too. Doesn't matter if you're not a man and You're not white. Doesn't matter. You're all white supremacists.
That's not a white man.
I don't. I'm just like, but people are calling out. They're just like, you're acting like a giant baby. You know, people don't have to like your shows. And it's become a joke now that if something doesn't do well in Hollywood, it's because of Islamophobia, white supremacy, or some other lame ass bullshit. People are not falling for your crap anymore.
Yeah.
So just stop with it. You just say, okay, I made a show people don't like.
Yeah. I mean, no, you can't do that. We can't own any mistakes in Hollywood. And that's what we talk about here is that, like, look, you know, sometimes Hollywood, a lot of times makes shitty movies and TV shows. Mm-hmm. And yeah, sometimes there's a political element to it. Sometimes people don't like it just because it's a shitty idea that's executed poorly. Mm-hmm. And it didn't land the way you thought it was going to land. And yeah, maybe stop smoking pot when you're coming up with these pitches.
Right. But Seth Rogen has continually been kind of an asshat. And, you know, it's like pick your pick. There's a different one every few months that he shows up again being an asshat for something. If I hear his name, I just keep walking. I don't even stop and look unless I have to. Because I'm just like, oh, he's just a grumpy, ass mad douchebag. So I don't even pay attention.
I'm really concerned about Darkwing Duck. I think this is going to be another one of those things where, you know, I know it's going to be bad. I don't want to watch it. Because I know you can never replicate that, mm-hmm. especially not with Seth Rogen mm-hmm. involved or in charge, especially not with him in charge. And it might be one of those things where it's like, yeah, I might be better off not watching this because it's just going to make me angry.
Well, here's the thing, too. At least it was their own thing and it was their own new thing, which normally I support. But... Because it wasn't like they were trying to use like a nostalgia, like Darkwing or whatever. It was their own thing. But it's still done in such a way that people just are like, why you doing it? And it's okay. People don't like it. They don't have to like it. But when the way he behaved and reacted to it is the problem. And people are calling him out. Basically, it's, I don't like your show, so it's white supremacy. Because they cannot deal fundamentally, especially Seth Rogen for whatever reason, cannot deal with the concept that maybe people don't think that their vision is great and they love their stuff.
Does pot turn you into a pussy?
Because I have no idea.
It seems like all these Hollywood types smoke a lot of pot and brag about smoking a lot of pot. They're all a bunch of pussies. Mm-hmm. They can't take criticism at all. They can dish it out.
Oh, yeah. He loves to throw shit at everybody else. But it's like that meme where those shits come back on him. Oh, my God, oppression.
I think pot turns you into a pussy.
I have no idea.
I really do. I guess the Nazis have taken...
There's people who smoke pot that aren't. Though, I'm sure.
I think Variety has been overrun
those
by Nazis. The Yahtzees have taken over Variety and the like two or three other media outlets that actually dared review this garbage tier mm-hmm. show. This is something though, dude. I would get this laminated. I'd put this in the office wall. So when people come into your office, you know, first they'd smell pot, but then they would look up and see, hey, dude, you're talking to the guy who has the lowest rated TV show ever. Mm-hmm. The lowest
that
in the whole
takes
world.
Quite a bit of skill.
The whole fucking world.
I even beat Hungry.
He beat out Hungry. Like, that is skill.
It's that bad. It's that bad. It's across several review platforms. But it's not even just them. The media outlets, there's some that gave it a good review too. But a lot of them would give it a good review, but they'd also say, but it was pretty bad here, 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 and here. Everyone who doesn't like it is just a white supremacist because Seth Rogen said so.
He's just insufferable. He's just, I mean, look.
Oh, I haven't been able to stand him. If he's in anything, I turn it off. I haven't been able to stand him for years.
I liked him
far up his own ass.
Oh, yeah. Like 10 years ago, like I said, he was kind of like the relatable everyman kind of Hollywood type. And then he's completely up his own ass.
It's the arrogance of some of these people. And it just blows my mind how arrogant they are. And they cannot deal with the fact that they'll tell everybody else that they're hot, their takes are shit and they're a bunch of garbage. And they'll probably say that the videos we do are crap. And he's been known to go after people for saying things he didn't like, whatever, don't care. But you're not allowed to criticize anything he does. You know, he's so out of touch. It's ridiculous. Some people might like the show. And that's completely fine. You're allowed to like it. I don't care if you like it.
It might be such a train wreck that it's worth watching just to see how bad
it
actually is.
You probably would find it funny. I don't think it's my kind of movie or show. I just don't think it is.
Well, I like South Park, so
Yeah. Well, this is probably worse than that.
Oh yeah, South Park's funny. That's the difference.
Taking a side detour here for a minute, I want to point out they've gone about anti-Semitism or whatever because, you know, apparently because he's Jewish and Silverman's Jewish. Squicking brought up a good point. He's like, there is a big lack in Hanukkah-based shows.
Yeah, really? I mean, your representation is a shitty Adam Sandler cartoon. We don't need more Santa.
That's it. But they make a show where they're shitting on Santa because it's not something they care about. You know, and it's like, but it's funny. It's all it's supposed to be meant to be funny. But apparently, I think they made it too political. I think if it was just going for raunch and fun, people wouldn't be so mad. But it sounds like they're mad because they made it very, very political.
Like, you know, Santa could have been like a porn star. Like, that's what Santa does the rest of the year. Like, he's a porn star 364 days out of the year. And then, you know, one night a year, he puts
Santa's
pants
only
on.
Fans.
Yeah, Santa's OnlyFans. You could have gone that
way. You
know
route. What? We joke, but there probably is a Santa OnlyFans. I don't want to know.
Oh, shit. Is don't that like tell Reindeer me. Cam? Santa's... We used to watch the Reindeer Cam. Remember Reindeer Cam? The kids loved that.
They did like
this
that.
This is like some guy's backyard.
But, you know, it was sweet that he did that. And he would come out and feed the reindeer and stuff. Yeah, it was. My kids loved it.
That's what I'm going to do when I retire.
But anyway.
We're going to get some reindeer. Now, we're in Pennsylvania, so we'll just go out in the woods and just go find some deer. And I'll just.
I like my deer friends, so. But...
Put some bells on them.
I mean, at the end of the day, I have no desire to see the show. I'm not even going to talk about the show based on merit because I honestly am not going to watch it to be fair about it. I'm just talking about his reaction to it, which is, again, like what we're seeing all the time with Hollywood. You don't like it, so it's because you're a white supremacist. You don't like it, it's because you're an alt-right Yahtzee. You don't like it, it's because you're a misogynist. You don't like it, it's because you're some kind of istophobic person because instead of owning my flaws, I'm going to somehow project it onto you so you're always a bad person and I'm always somehow morally superior and superior to you in every way. No one's falling for your shit anymore.
Yeah, and this is like, I mean, the drama of the freaking week with him anymore. Like, nobody's heard of Seth, nobody's really cared about Seth Rogen for years and all of a sudden he won't shut up. Mm-hmm. Like,
no, he pops up every so often, is a douche about something and then people talk about him for like a week and then they forget about him again.
It's like herpes.
I don't know.
It's like you forget you
is
have it.
Is there a
it.
Shot for Seth Rogen?
You forget you have it. And it's like, oh, God, I got the sores again. What the hell's going on? Seth Rogen. I got Seth Rogen in my mouth. My God.
God, I don't want him anywhere near my mouth. Anyway.
Yeah, but he's like going after YouTubers and he's, yeah. It's like, come on. You know, LA's great. Yeah, if you live in a gated community in a multi-million dollar mansion, mm-hmm. I'm sure it is fantastic.
And what gets me is the kids doing these movies and things that don't do well, and they just keep putting them in charge of things. I just don't understand it.
Oh, Darkwing Duck is so screwed.
So, anyway.
I'm so dreading.
I don't know whose bright idea that was.
They were high.
He was, but whose bright idea at Disney was?
Somebody at Disney was also high. That's the only explanation. It's the same with Masters of the Universe. Who'd call up Kevin Smith, somebody who was high?
I mean, they want some kind of pop culture name associated. They figured Kevin Smith already ruined stuff because of him going out against Disney for other things. So we'll call Seth Rogen up? I don't... Now, look, Darkwing Duck.
The sausage party guy. We're going to get the sausage party
guy. That's what I don't understand.
Darkwing Duck. What are you thinking?
I, you know, Darkwing Duck and Chippendale could be totally good.
No.
It's possible.
No, it won't happen.
It's possible. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt until he shows me otherwise.
That's the problem. We keep giving people the benefit of the doubt.
I always will stand by you should give people the benefit of the doubt until they show you otherwise. But I'm not holding my breath. Let's put it that way. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt, but I'm not holding my breath that it's going to be fantastic. I will be fair. I'm not watching this shit show, though. Santa Inc.
Oh,
not happening.
No. No.
You couldn't pay me enough to watch the show. So, can we wrap this up now?
Yeah, let's wrap it up. Like a douche. No, that's
what?
It's not actually the lyrics. Everybody thinks
do you know
like
how douches
wrapped
work?
Wrapped up like a douche. It's actually wrapped up like a deuce.
Yeah, that makes sense.
I thought it was wrapped up like a douche.
There'd be no reason to wrap up a douche.
Yeah, no, that's... I don't know how douches work, really, because I've never used one.
Yeah, clearly. Okay, confirmed. Neon doesn't know how a douche works. Okay, let's wrap this up.
Well, yeah, I don't know how he keeps getting work. It just, they keep giving him jobs. I don't know.
Well, he obviously isn't a douche because he's got that not so fresh feeling. His brain needs one. Anyway.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We'll talk later.
Bye.